Hello everyone. Now in BCom semester 5, business statistics unit 3, index number. We completed all types of long sums. Right now we are going to start short sums. Okay. We are divide short sums in two parts. First based on last pair Pashe, Fisher, Bowley and Marshall. Okay. And second one based on cost of living index number. See, this is our first sum. If Fisher's index number equal to 130, last pair is equal to 135.2, find P. Okay, very easy sum. Is a very easy sum solution. Write down formula of Fisher. Fisher equal to under root of last pair into Marshall. Okay, L into P. Therefore, Fisher is equals to 130. Equals to under root of 135.2 last pair, 135.2 into partial. Okay, now squaring both sides. Anne baju square kar diye. So first 130 square equal to 169.00. 169.00. It is equals to under root. Now square karo to so 135.2 multiplied by P. Therefore, Pashe's index number is equals to 169.00 divided by 135.2. And we will get Pashe's index number P equal to divided by 135.2 is equals to 125. This is our answer, 125. Pashe's index number is 125. Our second sum is if sigma p1 q0 is equal to 656, sigma p0 q0 320, sigma p1 q1 800 and p0 q1 is equals to 480. Question is find last pair Pashe, Fisher, Bowley and Marshall. So it is also very easy sum because p see here 1000 means it is last pair 1000 and 1101 it is Pashe. Okay, so first we have to find last pair and Pashe's index number. First, last pair's index number is equals to sigma p1q0 divided by sigma p0q0 into 100 and it is equals to p1q0 656 sequence ma japelu che divided by 320 multiplied by 100. Okay, and it is equals to 656 multiplied by, sorry, divided by 320 into 100. It is equals to 205. Okay. Pashe's index number P is equals to sigma P1 Q1 upon sigma P0 Q1 multiplied by 100. And it is equals to 800 divided by 480 into 100 and we will get 800 divided by 480 into 100 166.67. okay, let me check again. 800 divided by 480. Okay, whatever. Now third one is Fisher's index number. F is equals to under root of L into P. Okay. And it is equals to under root of 205 into 166.67. Okay. Multiply both the amounts then by taking under root. So 205 multiplied by 166.67. You will get 34167.35 and under root is 184.84. Okay, now find Pauli's index number. B is equals to L plus P upon 2 arithmetic mean. Okay, so L plus P, wait. L plus P equal to 205 plus 166.67. Divided by 2 and it is equals to 205 plus 166.67 divided by 185.84. Sorry, 185.84. 185.80. Okay, and now our last one is Marshall's index number. M is equals to sigma P1Q0 plus sigma P1Q1 divided by sigma P0Q0 plus sigma P0Q1 multiplied by 100. And it is equals to P1Q0. See here, 320 plus P1Q1 800 divided by P0Q0 320 and 480. Sorry, P0Q0 320. Yeah, actually P1Q0 is 656. 656. 320 plus 480 into 100. Okay. Now, total of numerator is 1456 and total of denominator is 800 multiplied by 100. Okay, 00 cancel out. So 1456 divided by 8. 182. Marshall's index number is 182. Okay. Our third sum is if sigma P1Q1 is 2, sigma P0Q1 equal to 3:2 and P1Q0 is 2, P0Q0 equal to 7:5. Obtain Fisher's and Bowley's index number. Okay, so we can directly find Fisher's and Bowley's index number, but if we find the last pair and Paschal's index number, the calculation of Fisher and Bowley is very easy for us. Hali Fisher ki do hai to apne directly find kari shakte. So first of all, we have to find last pairs and Paschal's index number. See, first sigma P1Q1 is to sigma P0Q1 is equals to what? 3 by 2 is given. Okay, see, so use first identity here. Okay, now multiply both sides by 100 and we will get sigma P1Q1 upon sigma P0Q1 multiplied by 100 equal to 3 by 2 is 1.5 into 100. Okay, what is this? This is a formula of Paschal. Paschal's index number is equals to 150. Okay, so we get Paschal's index number. Okay, now use second thing. Sigma P1Q0 divided by sigma P0Q0. It is equals to 7 by 5. Multiply both sides by 100 and we will get sigma P1Q0 upon sigma P0Q0 into 100 equal to 7 by 5 into 100. Okay. So this is formula of last pair. So last pair's index number is equals to 25 times is 100 and 20 into 7 is 140. Last pair's index number and Paschal's index number are respectively 140 and 150. Okay. Right now we have to find Fisher's and Bowley's index number. So Fisher's index number is equals to under root of L multiplied by P. It is equals to under root of 150. Last pair is given by 140. Order is not matter, but after order one lucky 140 into like both the numbers, then by taking under root 140 into 150, 21,000, and under root is 144.91. Okay, now Bowley's index number. Bowley's index number V is equals to L plus P by 2. So L is equals to 140 plus P. 150 divided by 2, it becomes 145 because it is mid value of 140 and 150. So Bowley's index number is 145. Our next sum is if the ratio of last pair and Fisher's index number is 25 is to 24 and Pasha's index number is 115.2. Find last pairs and Fisher's index number. Okay. So first of all, in solution, write down what is given. Last pair is to Fisher is given by 25 is to 24. And Pasha's index number is given by 115.2. Question is asking for last pair and Fisher's index number. Okay, so let us start our sum. First, we are going with this ratio. L is to F can be written as L upon F equal to 25 by 24. Okay, now L upon, what is formula of Fisher's index number? So the under root of L into P equal to 25 by 24. Now squaring both sides and we will get L square upon under root set L into P equal to 25 square 625 upon 576. Okay. Now L cancel out. Therefore L is equals to what? 625 upon 576 multiplied by P. P then yahan apne move kare. L equal to 625 upon 576 multiplied by P. P is 115.2. 115.2. Therefore, L equal to what? 625 divided by 576 multiplied by 115.2. It is 125. Our answer is 125. Last pair's index number is 125. Okay. Now, after getting last pair and Pasha, we can easily find Fisher's index number. Okay. What is formula of Fisher's index number? F is equals to under root L into P equal to under root of L. Here we find 125. And P is given by 115.2. Now multiply both the amount and then by taking under root 125 into 115.2 equal to 14,400 and under root should be 120. Yes, 120 it is 120. So Fisher's index number is equal to 120. Our next sum is last pair's index number is 4 by 5 times Fisher's index number. If Fisher's index number is 120, find partial index number. So is also very easy question. Okay, first of all, write down content given in our question. Last pair's index number is 4 by 5 times of Fisher's index number, and Fisher's index number is given by 120. Question is asking for Pasha's index number, but for Pasha, first we have to find last pair's index number. Okay, so L is equals to last pair's index number L is equals to 4 by 5 into F. It is equals to, sorry, not by F, it is F, 4 upon 5 into F. Fisher's index number is given by 120. Okay, so 120 by 5 into 4 or 4 by 5 into 120. It is equals to 96. Pasha's index number is 96. Now find out, last pair's index number is 96. Now for Pasha's index number, we have to put formula Fisher. Fisher is equals to under root of L into P. Hume easy pade, ke mate pehle thi square karna ko to pan chale like. Therefore, F square is equals to L into P. Okay, therefore, P equal to what? F square upon L. Aar ite pan solve karai. Now putting value. Therefore, P equal to F square. F equal to 120 square divided by 96. Okay, therefore Pasha's index number is 12 square 144 and 00 divided by 96. Therefore P is equals to 14400 divided by 96. We will get 150. Okay, so answer is 150. ઓકે સો આઈ હોપ કે લાસ્ટ પેર પાસે ફિશર ઉપર શોર્ટ સમ જે આપણે સોલ્વ કરીએ તમને ખ્યાલ આવી ગયો હશે ઇન્ડેક્સ નંબરમાં આમ તો લાસ્ટ પેર પાસે ઉપરથી ઘણા બધા હજી સમ્સ બની શકે બટ બેઝિક ફાઉન્ડેશન આ છે, આટલી વસ્તુ તમને આવડે એટલે બાકી કોઈ પણ સમ તમે સોલ્વ કરી શકો. સો વી વિલ મીટ નેક્સ્ટ વિડીયો વિથ શોર્ટ સમ્સ ઓફ કોસ્ટ ઓફ લિવિંગ ઇન્ડેક્સ નંબર.